NBC, I challenged them, why do you only have one-sided representation? You must always have two sides to a story if you want to inform our people. Then they told me ministers refused to appear. And one minister admitted when I challenged him. Ministers refused to appear on TV to explain their policies. Now you get five people sitting there, all just condemning the government. And nobody is there to correct it. It's true in most cases, NBC goes and select their own people whom they want to expose certain view. On the other hand, my office is available, ministers are available, some of them, but when you are interviewed even for 1 hour, you give your time. When is this going to be published or broadcast? 1 minute, disjointed, voice overrun, and therefore your message is not coming out. You are interviewed by press, and you are talking, have a parenthetical expression, and then you go on. That expression becomes the main item. How do we educate our people? Let them distort the stories. How am I going to get him? I overheard people saying, when they're going to interview, they say, how am I going to get him today? It's not to get me, to get the information, to inform the people there. You are a transmission belt. And you have Facebook, you have your own. These days, they're not the only ones who can reach the public. We have Facebooks, we have what? You can tweet. So we'll do that. So from now on, if I'm issue a thing is misrepresented, I'll issue my own statement in my own other sources. And need be, we'll pay the NBC or one-on-one to put a paid version of the government. Distortions cannot be allowed to destroy what we are doing.
He also lashed out at cabinet ministers for not giving information to the media on time or for not availing themselves.
Press is claiming that the ministers never answered with their queries. The ministers are afraid now. They say, some of them, because when they appear, things are distorted. People come with a preconceived notion, already decided what they are going to put in the paper. Just ask him. Not even listening when they say, yeah, minister, you are going to do this. Oh, thank you. Not input of the ministers included. It's already written 2 days ago. That's going to be published. That way we are losing confidence in one another and trust in one another. We fail to account to one another. You cannot blame this government of not being open to the press. Definitely not. But what do we get in return? What do we get in return? Good intentions of trying to be transparent. Wishy-washy reports. Not seriously informing people in what I am saying, ministers are saying. You are a transmission belt. You are a fourth estate. We cannot do without you. And country cannot do without you. But if we are playing a game of exposing one another, catching one another, in editorials, you have your right. Let my information be conveyed as I'm giving it. But in your editorials, you have a right to tear me to pieces, but not in a news item. How do you convey the information to the citizenry? You are a conveyor belt, fourth estate, very important. So ministers, some of them, use that excuse, maybe, and are shying away.